Cartoon recaps here. Today I will be recapping the movie called The Legend of Deification. Spoilers ahead, relax and enjoy. Long ago, the world was at peace and prosperity. Suddenly the Fox clan brought chaos to the world and the clan was led by a nine-tailed demon. The nine-tailed demon transforms herself into Daji, royal consort, and took over the throne. The heavens took pity on the people in their sufferings, and summons the heavenly warriors to their aid. Which was led by Zhang Ziya. The battle between the Fox clan and heavenly warriors started. And fortunately the heavenly warriors vanquished the Fox clans. Zhang Ziya, the heavenly warrior's leader, confronts Fox clan leader and defeated her, by using a seal to subdue her and then captures her forever. 10 years later after the defeat of the Fox clan, everyone praised and respected Zhang Ziya for his heroic efforts in the war. For his contributions, he was summoned to a place in heaven called the Jingxu Hall, which is a demon executing stand. The gods tells Zhang Ziya that the nine-tailed demon he captured cannot be allowed to live. They told him to slay her and after that, he will finally be given his place as the leader of the gods. And from that moment on, everyone from both the heavens and the earth will answer to his will. Without hesitation, Zhang Ziya agrees to slay her. When the demon is presented in front of him, Zhang Ziya is about to kill her. Until the demon gets into his head and showed him what will happen if she is killed. That an innocent girl that her life is linked to, will also die. Due to this, Zhang Ziya couldn't harm the demon. And as a punishment for him holding back, and the heavens took away his powers and banished him to the North Sea, until he comes back to his senses. 10 years has passed, and the earth is empty of human lives, it's only filled with different kind of creatures and few humans. Because during the war, many people were killed. Zhang Ziya is still thinking about the vision about the little innocent girl linked to the nine-tailed demon. He is joined by a heavenly warrior called Sean, who is giving the responsibility to watch over Zhang Ziya, until he recovers from the nine-tailed demon illusions. He is so frustrated that Zhang Ziya can't get off his mind from the girl he saw in the nine-tailed demon illusions. And tries to convince him that it was just the demon trick to fool him. Sean is tired and wants to go back to heaven and Zhang Ziya tells him to go that it's the one that should be getting punished not him. This annoys Sean for Zhang Ziya's stubbornness. But there is nothing he can do since he has already been given order from the heavens, to help Zhang Ziya recover from the demon illusions, only then can he return to heaven. Zhang Ziya strolls alone in the North Sea and comes across some demons and humans in a bar, who hated him for not slaying the nine-tailed demon. Because of that, they are all imprisoned in the North Sea. They started to call him a scum of the realms. Suddenly, a girl called Xiao Ju enters the bar. Everyone is so skeptical of her because they haven't seen her before. When Zhang Ziya sees her, he recognizes her to be the girl whom he saw in the nine-tailed demon illusions. That is linked to the nine-tailed demon. She demands from the other demons to know where she can find a place very unique. Where the black flowers bloom. She's offering a bag of gold to anyone who has an answer. The bar owner seemed to have an answer, and shows her a map on where she can find what she's looking for. Immediately Jevi attempts to steal the map, which causes commotion in the bar, as the other demons grabs the opportunity to steal something from the bar too. Suddenly the bar owner throws an axe on her, which she dodges it, but it reveals her identity. It turns out the Xiao Ju is a fox demon, in which they all believe to be evil, for the fox clans brought chaos to their land. They insult her and wanted to even present for to the heavens, so they can regain their freedom. But luckily for her, she makes her escape while as for Zhang Ziya, he chases after her. Sean sees him from afar and tries to stop him, knowing that if Zhang Ziya passes the boundary of the North Sea, it means he is defying the heavens' orders. After a long chase, the fox demon manages to escape from him. Sean begs him not to cross the boundary but Zhang Ziya did it anyway, telling Sean that he will only return only when he finds the truth. Suddenly, Zhang Ziya manages to capture Xiao Ju, the fox demon. And questions her on how she's connected to the fox demon but instead, she tries to run again. Suddenly, the nine-tailed demon tries to capture her, but with Zhang Ziya's help with his powers, he is able to rescue her. Zhang Ziya wants to know why the nine-tailed demon is after her but she doesn't seem to have an idea, due to she has lost her memories. The only thing that can help her regain her memories is the black flowers she's looking for. Zhang Ziya is really afraid because he thinks he might be falling into the nine-tailed demon traps but instead, he decides to help her to find the black flowers she's looking for. On their way, Xiao Ju tries to steal the map so many times, but is stopped by Zhang Ziya pet known as, four alike. Who stops her especially when she tries to do anything stupid. They arrived in a deserted land where they come across a man who dying of thirst. Zhang Ziya is about to help but immediately the man sees Xiao Ju, He is afraid and attacks her because he believes she's an evil fox demon. Xiao Ju tries to attack back, but Zhang Ziya stops her and attends to the man, only to see Xiao Ju making her escape. The man dies, warning Zhang Ziya that where they are heading to, which is Mount Yudu, there are fox demons there. Xiao Ju is on her journey alone when she encounters some strange monsters coming out of the ground. It tries to attack her, but Zhang Ziya comes to her rescue. He tells her to escape with four alike, while he fights the monster. Zhang Ziya faces the monster, but it is really too strong for him. Xiao Ju is escaping with four alike, but when four alike senses he can't handle the situation alone, it goes back to help. Xiao Ju, not wanting to leave them all alone, goes back to help too. Together they are able to fight off the monster and make their escape. Zhang Ziya tells her that those things that attacked them were not monsters but resentful souls. Lost souls, those who left their homes and died on the battlefield. Later that night, Xiao Ju had a nightmare when she was roaming about during the end of the war. She sees a little child hungry and tries to give him food. But the little child father attacks her with the other villagers, calling her a demon. They tried to kill her, immediately she wakes up from her sleep. As Zhang Ziya and Xiao Ju are on their way when Sean confronts them with anger. He thinks Xiao Ju has possessed Zhang Ziya or something. That's why he doesn't want to return to heaven. He attacks her, but Zhang Ziya defends her, while she makes her escape. She is captured by the god of marriage, who strangles her only to bring out the nine-tailed demon out of her. The nine-tailed demon later captures Xiao Ju, while Zhang Ziya and Sean, seeing this, follows them. The nine-tailed tells Zhang Ziya that the heavens were the ones that tried to sacrifice Xiao Ju, so that they can trap her. Zhang Ziya doesn't want to believe that heavens will ever sacrifice a little girl to trap the nine-tailed fox demon. Zhang Ziya, not wanting to hear any more words for her, attacks her along with Sean. And with the support of four alike, they were able to save Xiao Ju and escape. On their way, four alike falls down from the injury it obtained from the nine-tailed demon. Zhang Ziya tries his best to stop the bleeding, but it is too late. Four alike died. Which leaves Zhang Ziya and Xiao Ju in pain. Zhang Ziya still feels unsettled about what the demon said about using Xiao Ju as a sacrifice to trap the nine-tailed demon. So he go to heaven to find out the truth for himself. The heavens tells him that it was necessity they had to take to sacrifice one life to save all lives. Zhang Ziya convinces the heavens to help him guide the girl to reincarnation, which will kill the fox spirit. The heavens agrees, and he appreciates the them and heads back. Zhang Ziya and Sean carry Xiao Ju to the gate of reincarnation. And uses his magic to open the gate. They hear the nine-tailed demon approaching, and Sean tells him to do whatever he can do to save her, while he stays at the gate to hold the demon off. The demon then confronts Sean, and they both went on a one-on-one fight. After a long fight, Sean gets killed by the nine-tailed demon. Zhang Ziya successfully carries Xiao Ju to the chamber of reincarnation. But suddenly, the nine-tailed demon arrives and destroys the chamber of reincarnation. The fox clan is now released. Zhang Ziya questions the nine-tailed demon why those spirit hasn't been reincarnated yet, and the demon replies that long ago she was sent to vanquish the fox clan, and as a reward, the heavens will make her a god, and the spirits will be reincarnated. But when she did what the heavens asked from her, the heavens broke their promise. Suddenly, the nine-tailed demon then absolves all the fox clan spirits, making her the most powerful demon. The heads to heaven while Zhang Ziya tries to save Xiao Ju. Until he discovers that his real powers doesn't come from heaven but from his self-confidence. Zhang Ziya unleashed his powers on the nine-tailed demon, which killed it. And as he tries to rescue the Xiao Ju, it turns out that heavens has already killed her. The heavens appreciated Zhang Ziya for killing the nine-tailed demon and asks him to bow before them, so he can be given his place as a god. But he refused, not wanting to bow before an unjust god. He then uses his powers to close all the links between the heavens and the earth. And makes all those who have died reincarnate again. Thank you for watching, guys. If you love animation movies, please subscribe to this channel and keep watching. Bye.